So military watches, it's a term and phrase that kind of gets thrown around pretty loosely and has transcended the idea of watches just being used for military personnel. It's created, I think, its own subcategory of type of collectors out there that just want watches that either appeal to the military type of aesthetic or watches that are actually produced for use in military type of settings. So in this video, we're gonna be looking at a variety of different categories, both watches for land, air, as well as sea, as you have to have the right tool for the job. And you're probably looking at myself and thinking, what is this guy with this J.Crew button up gonna tell me about military watches? And to you, you kind of have a point. So I also had some backup on this video as well as the blog down below that looks at even 25 more military watches to consider here that we're not gonna be able to cover all of them. So definitely check that out. But Ben Lowry is a new member of the team. He was a diver and he is a avid military watch enthusiast. So he was very helpful in helping to put together this list. So definitely check that out down below. Now to start us off here, we're gonna be looking at watches built for the sea. So just some criteria here. They have to have healthy enough water resistance, solid durability, have to be able to have great legibility both underwater as well as in nighttime elements, and also has an elapsed time measurement. So rotating bezel, for example, or a stopwatch feature. Now, first up, we have probably the most affordable option with the Casio G-Shock and looking at a specific reference with the DW9052. So when I think a lot of people consider military watch, I think many consider the G-Shock. Some places and applications, the G-Shock is actually not a great choice given the fact that some of them have Bluetooth and there's some security issues with that. But in this instance, when looking at the sea, this is a great option for under $100. 48.5 millimeter case is certainly going to be larger on the wrist, 200 meters of water resistance, nice battery life. But when looking at G-Shocks, you're really looking at the fact that these things can take shock, they're hardy, they're cheap, and they're reliable, and they'll just keep on telling time. And these watches, this DW9052 is actually currently the standard issue at the Naval Diving and Salvage Training Center in Panama City Beach, Florida, and is actually issued to all the divers with their fins, masts, and knives. Now next up, we have Luminox with their original Navy SEAL. Now Luminox is a pretty young brand, but pretty interesting one at that. They really prioritize this market of military style watches, and they definitely pander quite a bit in terms of their marketing and messaging to this type of consumer, which can get a little bit exhausting. But when they do their watches, when you just look at the watches on the surface and just see what they're actually producing, they do have a nice watch for this general range. This Navy SEAL coming in just south of $400, very lightweight on the wrist with this carbon case. It's gonna actually be even lighter than many G-Shock. You kind of take that analog display though, instead of that more digital display, Swiss quartz movement within 200 meters of water resistance, and the watches are pretty much light as a feather on the wrist. If you do look past the cheesy marketing, you do find a pretty solid watch that will certainly fit right in the lane of this type of consumer. Now, when looking at professional dive watches from an affordable perspective, over the last 5 to 10 years, the watches that get mentioned the most are the Seiko SKX007 and the 009. They since have gone up in price quite a bit, but I do want to include them on this list here today just because with their ISO certification, no nonsense looks, and just being time tested, they're favorites amongst military personnel and people that are professional divers. These watches have a wearable case size for their diameter, nice 200 meters of water resistance, again, ISO rated divers, fantastic lume for the money. You are getting an automatic 7S26, so no hacking here, but certainly does the job. And if you're just shooting for that mustache toting 1990s, Navy SEAL look, you should be right at home with these pieces on your wrist. Now, when considering dive watches from Japan at an affordable level, I think a lot of people think Seiko, but you should also, of course, consider Citizen. And when you're thinking about from a military perspective, a watch that's going to be very reliable, it's really set it and forget it. The EcoDrive movements are going to be probably the best in their class. So the watch we're going to be looking at here is the Citizen ProMaster Aqualand. So this watch, a little bit on the higher end for the EcoDrive watches at just under $700, but you are getting some nice up spec here in terms of some other additional features. So you're getting a very legible display here and an accurate integrated depth gauge, which is going to be very helpful as excellent backup for divers using a diving computer. Solar charging with that EcoDrive movement, 200 meters of water resistance, so certainly going to be able to stand up to many of the strenuous conditions. Definitely going to be larger on the wrist, but as a byproduct of that, going to be incredibly legible. Now, when you're looking at when dive watches became popular amongst military personnel in the U.S., the Vietnam War was really that transition point, with many of these watches becoming popular at PXs and being available there. And one of the watches that kind of transitions into this overall realm of the Vietnam War, but mostly because of pop culture with a popular movie, is with the Seiko Captain Willard. Now, these watches were recently reintroduced, the SPB-151 and then the SPB-153, and they're actually updated takes on the Seiko 6105-8110, the dive watch that was made famous by Captain Willard, well, actually Martin Sheen in the movie Apocalypse Now. So these watches walk that fine line of being modern, yet very wearable in terms of their case size, 42.7 millimeters and a 46.6 millimeter lug to lug distance. You have a couple different dial options to choose from, the green dial variant, and then also the black dial variant, also being available on a rubber strap. And you also have a bracelet version, 200 meters of water resistance, and the updated 70 hour power reserve automatic Seiko 6R35. So you're getting some nice upgrades from the Seiko 6R15 with that 50 hour power reserve that would come on that one. So you're getting a nice upgrade from the 6R15 with that 50 hour power reserve. This watch might be included on this list partially because of its pop cultural relevance and what wrist it was on the big screen, but certainly one to add on this list is a cool one to consider. Now for our last dive watch here, we have the Marathon GSAR Government Search and Rescue. So the 41 millimeter option, there are a few different actual sizes to choose from, 36 millimeter for those with smaller wrists, as well as the jumbo option, which is going to scale this thing out quite a bit. But for those larger wristed individuals, certainly one to consider. I think this one is in the sweet spot. So Marathon, Canadian brand, Swiss made watches, have been producing watches for the Allied forces since the 1940s and have become popular as a result of their military issued timepieces, with their watches still being used by US military personnel as well as Canadian armed forces as well. The intrigue for this watch is it's just pretty much no nonsense, 300 meters of water resistance, sapphire crystal, automatic ETA movement within, and the use of tritium tubes on the dial really being the calling card here, as those tritium tubes are gonna stack quite high. So you're gonna have this really recessed dial that sits far within the case, which is very cool. It makes the watch seem very tactical in its approach, which I think is a really big selling factor in why these watches are so popular. Okay, so now we're gonna be looking at the air category. So a little bit of criteria here first. First, the watches have to have pressure resistance here to be able to be worn in the cockpit. Also have to have legibility in mind, so nice contrast, use of lume or some luminescent material, and then a second or third time zone is a bonus here. Now to start us off, looking back at Marathon with their Navigator. Now the Navigator, very similar to what the GSAR does for military personnel in the more aquatic point of view, this is doing it from the pilot watch perspective. This one is going to be a quartz movement, more affordable in its price, around $300. ETA, Swiss quartz movement within, 60 meters of water resistance, which is serviceable for the most part, but might be nice to see a little bit more there. You're getting an asymmetrical case style that's very similar to the Benrus Type 1, Type 2 case style that was popular from that brand. Super lightweight, low pressure resistance for its use in the cockpit for pilots. And that asymmetrical case kind of works as crown guards to protect that crown on the 3 o'clock side. Now, considering pilot watches, I think the Flieger design is so much a source of inspiration for so many other manufacturers out there. But when you look at the original five that were doing it and creating it for the German Air Force back in World War II, you have a short list. So you have Laco, you have Stova, Vempe, Lange, as well as IWC. But from a more affordable perspective, I think the best places to look are with Stova as well as Laco. The one we're gonna be looking at today is the Laco Original Westerlin. So one thing that I think Laco does very well is both on the affordable end as well as replicating many of the watches that were used during this period. So the watch that we have here is a Type A style dial. So there's a Type A, Type B style Flieger design. This one came with the large markers along the outside, triangular marker at the 12 for orientation, but unlike the Type B with the minutes on the outside, the hours are going to be marked here instead. And then also to pay tribute to the classic style of these, larger case size. This one at 45 millimeters, the originals were at 55 millimeters to be worn over the pilot jackets of pilots during World War II, which really helped with legibility and being able to check the time at simply a glance. This one comes with 50 meters of water resistance and a hand wound movement, an ETA 28012, which is very true to the originals. In addition though, legibility on these are fantastic. Super Luminova on the dial, the hands, those leaf style hands, which is going to allow a pilot in this instance to be able to tell the time at such a quick glance, no matter what the conditions are. Now, when looking at military style watches, I think it's important for some of these not to get too expensive, but we're gonna have a couple exceptions on this list here when looking at the pilot perspective, because there are a lot of, I would say, military pilots that do wear expensive watches, or at least pilots that wear expensive watches when flying. And the one we're gonna be looking at here is the Breitling Aerospace. This one being the Evo Titanium. So north of $4,000 in price, but you are getting some interesting things in terms of what's happening here with the overall style. First, lightweight titanium case and bracelet on this piece. You're also getting some pilot specific features like a second time zone, alarm, calendar, 1/100th of a second chronograph, and a countdown timer. Battery life on these things, 3 to 4 years. You're getting a hybrid digital analog display on this piece. And from a pilot watch perspective and considering the entire landscape of watches, Breitling is certainly in the conversation for one with probably the most heritage in this arena. Now, one of my favorite brands out there is Zinn. I'm actually wearing a Zinn 556 right now, but instead with this watch we're gonna be looking at here is one of the high-tech Zinn watches that's out there, the Zinn EZM10 Test Half. So Zinn, a German tool watch brand based in Frankfurt, it was actually started by a flight instructor, Helmut Zinn, really does pride themselves on creating watches for actual use in the field. And this is a great example of that. This is a watch that is really just well thought out from top to bottom. First, you're getting incredible legibility on this piece, great contrast, and then also getting some additional features that typically come with these higher caliber Zinn watches. Comes also with a central 60-minute chronograph counter, which will help with timing additional events. You're also getting a titanium tegumented case, so this is gonna reduce scratches to an incredible degree. You're also getting Zinn's AR dehumidifying technology, which is going to allow the internal part of the case to resist fogging up while dealing with a variety of different temperatures between negative 45 degrees Celsius all the way up to 80 degrees Celsius. And the movement inside here is very highly modified. You're getting a modified Baojiu 7750, but this thing is completely reworked. The escapement is completely reworked, and you're also getting that additional, again, 60-minute chronograph counter. The pushers are very flush to the case. You almost, when looking at pictures of this piece or in person, can barely actually recognize that there are even chronograph pushers on here. They did a very good job in hiding those and keeping them very tucked to the case here. Certainly on the higher end of the price range here, but if you're looking at maybe one of the better constructed Zinn watches out there, this is certainly in the conversation. So the next category here is the land category. A few things to be included here. The watches need to be shock resistant. They also need to be sealed against dirt, grime, and be able to handle the taxing conditions of just being on the ground. And then also have some level of water resistance. So 50 meters, typically at least. Now, first up for this land category, we have the Sunto Traverse Alpha Foliage. Now, this is a watch that kind of combines the aspects that have become popularized with Garmin watches, some smartwatch functionality, and a watch that can be packaged in a way that can survive the hardship of military service. So this one coming in just south of $300, which is a little bit more attractive in the price tag. You're getting a large 50 millimeter wide but lightweight carbon case and every timekeeping, fitness, and tracking and navigation feature that you'll probably need. And compared to some other more affordable smartwatch hybrid watches out there, you're getting sapphire crystal, also battery life of 14 days on this as well. Now, when considering field watches for British military personnel, I think CWC is one of the better options out there. So from 1980 to 2008, these were watches that were actually issued by Britain's Ministry of Defense. So probably enough reason for you to maybe at least consider these watches, or at least to be put on your radar as solid watches from a field watch perspective. And the watches we're gonna be looking at here are the CWC G10 military issue. $380, 36.5 millimeter case, so very similar to the classic wearing dimensions of field watches from decades prior. You're also getting some nice roots here in history connected to this brand. You're also getting the battery hatch on the case back that can be opened up with a coin, allows the average watch nerd to easily just change batteries after somewhere around 5 years of trusty service. So getting some nice battery life out of these. You're also getting a Swiss quartz ETA within, 50 meters of water resistance, a little bit on the lower end, but certainly serviceable. Acrylic crystal, which is really gonna match that warm hue of field watches of years prior, and overall really solid watch to look at. Now from looking at British field watches and looking at American field watches, and I know this brand is no longer in the United States, but until 1969, they were in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. The Khaki collection is certainly, I think, one of the best options for $500. And I think can start getting into the category of military grade watches because they certainly made some in their heyday. And that is, of course, talking about Hamilton with their Hamilton Khaki Field Mechanical. Now, the Hamilton brand nowadays is not as much involved, of course, with the world of military issued watches that they were providing during World War I and World War II to Allied forces. But the Hamilton Khaki Field Mechanical, in many aspects, is the natural embodiment, the current embodiment of those watches from previous years. $495, 38mm case, 47mm lug to lug, wearable in a variety of different situations, put it on a variety of different straps, 50 meters of water resistance, you're getting a hand wound movement within, with an 80-hour power reserve and a sapphire crystal. Honestly, this is one of the best watches that you can find for around $500. And if you're looking for a watch of this overall styling, sure, maybe again, not too military spec, maybe not gonna be on the wrists of a lot of military personnel nowadays, but certainly has the looks to match it. And I could see somebody who is an enthusiast of this degree really liking this watch. And you're gonna be hard pressed to find a better one for the money. Now for our last watch here, we have the Garmin Tactics Delta. Now Garmin is probably one of the most popular brands amongst military personnel nowadays. $900 for this piece, so it's certainly on the more expensive end of watches of this category, but you're getting some fantastic features for the money. Heart rate monitoring, every timekeeping feature pretty much imaginable, access to a wide array of different apps, a customized display, GPS tracking with turn-by-turn directions, also has solar charging functionality as well, and even optical ballistics calculator for snipers, all in a fiber reinforced polymer case with a DLC coated bezel. So all this considered, I think the manufacturers knew exactly what target demographic they were going for with this timepiece. 100 meters of water resistance, so it's gonna be able to take on a variety of different situations. Sapphire crystal on this as well. Battery life 21 days in smartwatch mode. And currently these are super popular among special operations because of the many features with this watch, that GPS tracking, the fitness tracking, and those other tactical specific features. So guys, those are some military watches to be on your radar. If you are interested in seeing more, definitely check out the blog. I have over 25, I believe, mentioned in that blog down below. I'll leave it in the description. But if you did enjoy the video, thumbs up, subscribe, hit the bell icon. Love to see comments as well. What is your favorite watch that is of this ilk or this style? Love to see it down below. Also, be sure to stay up to date with the content by following us on Instagram. See some cool photos of watches as well. Head over to teddyballistar.com, full authorized dealer of 25 brands, full factory warranty, and one of the most trusted places to buy a watch online. But guys, thank you again so much for watching. Be well, and I will see you all very soon.